Please join us in singing our gathering song, found in your worship aid, Festival Canticle, Worthy is Christ.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, we gather this morning on this fourth Sunday of the Easter season, traditionally celebrated as Good Shepherd Sunday. It is also the Sunday of the World Day of Prayer for Vocations. So as we gather this morning as one family in faith, we first take a moment to pause and reflect on those times that we've sinned, so that we might prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you who shepherd us along the paths toward salvation, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you bid us to seek forgiveness of our sins and reconciliation to you. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you who are the shepherd who lays down his life for us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
We praise you, we bless you, we adore you.
joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach for the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said, "Leaders of the people and the elders, if we are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely by what means he was saved, then all of you and all the people of Israel should know that it was the name of Jesus Christ, Nazarene, who you crucified, who God raised from the dead, from the dead. In his name this man stands before you come. He is the stone rejected by you, the builders, which has become a cornerstone. There is no salvation for anyone else, nor is there any other name under heaven. It is in the name of grace by which are we to be saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God."
beloved. See what love the Father has bestowed on us, so that we may be called the children of God. And so we are. The reason that the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children. What we shall be has not been, meaning has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him. But we shall see him as he is, the Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And I know mine, and mine know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. And I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock, one shepherd. That is why the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down on my own. I have power to lay it down and power to take it up again. This command I have received from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So as Father Rick mentioned, it is the fourth Sunday of Easter. And it is known for obvious reasons as Good Shepherd Sunday. Well, first of all, let me start with two things. One of them is thank you to our third graders for doing the reading. Our third graders are preparing for the Sacrament of First Communion in 2 weeks. And so it's great that they're here with us today and leading us in the readings. You know, one of the things that they are doing is fulfilling a vocation. Calling. They are answering God's call by proclaiming God's word, the word that we read in the scripture. And so it's a great example to all of us. So thank you very much. The other thing is, boy, I just can't get over it. It's almost the end of April. This May is coming up really quick. And, you know, given last week's weather, I think we only got 4 or 5 more days of snow this summer or this year. Good Shepherd Sunday. One of the things that I've been doing recently, actually for the last year or so, is meeting with a group of other deacons and a couple of priests and doing spiritual companioning, spiritual direction. And we meet about once a month. We have a meal and we talk about
disciples. We are members of the body of Christ. And it is Christ who is our good shepherd, the good shepherd. It's Christ who is obviously talking about himself in the gospel today. And that needs to be foremost in our minds in almost everything that we do. Well, in everything we do, not almost, in everything that we do. Because that orients us, that sets our life on the stage in the proper place. It sets us on the proper path. Recognizing that Christ is the good shepherd. Christ is God himself who shares in our human nature, who lays down his life for us and takes it up again for our salvation. It is a mystery beyond comprehension that God loves us so much that God would do that. And so that's the first message that I think we need to receive from the gospel today and from this whole Good Shepherd World Day of Prayer for Vocations. Christ is the Good Shepherd, and that influences everything that we are and do. The second one is that many are called to special vocations. Vocations to the priesthood, vocations to the religious life, special vocations that ask of those who answer the call a lifetime of commitment, a lifetime of total commitment. It's a very great privilege, but there's also great responsibility associated with it, because in answering that call, there is the responsibility to try to emulate Christ in everything that they do, in everything that they teach. It's a great responsibility. And for that, we owe them a tremendous debt of gratitude. We owe them our allegiance and our following, just as we follow Christ. It's important that the shepherds lead us in the right direction and that we heed their call. We heed their lead. It's very important that we do that. The third group that I think we need to talk about today is all of the sheep, everyone else, because like those who are called to the priesthood and religious life, the consecrated life, to the clergy, we all have a vocation. We all have a calling, and that is to do God's will. Now, if you ever think about sheep, you never see a picture of a shepherd leading sheep in a pasture, and he has leashes on them all, and he's dragging them along, right? That's not what happens. That's not what the sheep are called to do. The sheep are called to follow the shepherd. And so that puts on us a tremendous responsibility, because we can't be passive in our vocation either. We can't be passive in our vocation of being disciples. We have to answer the call, and we have to answer it affirmatively. It's not good enough for us to say, yes, I'm a disciple of Christ. Yes, I believe in Christ as our Savior and Lord. We have to follow in the shepherd's footsteps, both the good shepherd and the shepherds who lead us in the church. Again, that's a great responsibility that's placed on us. But all of these responsibilities also bring us great joy, because we're doing what God calls us to do. St. Francis is asked in this year of St. Joseph to pray in a very special way to St. Joseph for all of those who are living out and for those who are also discerning their vocations. And so let's continue our Mass today praying to St. Joseph as we receive the Good Shepherd in the Eucharist, as we receive the Good Shepherd who has laid down his life for us and picked it up again. As we receive the Good Shepherd, who shares with us his very nature.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Heeding the voice of the Good Shepherd, and following in his footsteps, we lift up our prayers and petitions.
For the church, may we recognize your voice as our shepherd. Help us to wipe away the tears of all who suffer, especially those who have been victimized by the church. Let us pray to the risen Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own pastors and shepherds, Father Rick and Father Frank, and for all who minister in our faith community, may their compassion and welcoming service be a sign to all of their generous love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Ease the worries and the burdens our world carries. Open our hearts and minds to envision and support better ways of living, to practice thoughtfulness and compassion, and to work together for the common good. Let us pray to the risen Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for peace in our world, for calmness where there is division, mistrust, and violence. May we work together so that all people may find happiness. Let us pray to the risen Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved sick, dying, and grieving, and for those who care for them, let us pray to the risen Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Karen Nondorf, whom we remember in a special way at this liturgy, let us pray to the risen Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Merciful and loving Father, hear the prayers we offer to you this day with confidence and trust, and answer them according to your holy will. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Yeah.
my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of all children.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Mystery of faith. We breathe through his breath and drink with his
the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death we willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. And to make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Edward and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Robert our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
God is my shepherd, so nothing shall I want.
Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. We are protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and the other evil spirits who prowl about the world for the ruin of souls. Amen. In our vocation prayer, God our Father, you made each of us to use our gifts in the body of Christ. We ask that you inspire young people whom you call to the priesthood and consecrated life to courageously follow your will. Send workers into your great harvest so that the gospel is preached, the poor are served with love, the suffering are comforted, and your people are strengthened by the sacraments. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Some announcements this morning. The Mother's Day Memorial Flower envelopes are available in the vestibule. You can return them in the collection basket next week, or you can always drop them by the office. Altar and Rosary will be in the vestibule this morning with raffle tickets for the Mother's Day basket. So if you want to purchase raffle tickets, you can do that this morning. As Deacon Bill mentioned in his homily, today is the World Day of Prayer for Vocations. The Diocesan Vocation Office has provided us with these beautiful cards. This is also the year of St. Joseph. So the beautiful picture of St. Joseph and the baby Jesus on the front. And then there's a vocation prayer asking St. Joseph's intercession on the back in both English and Spanish. So feel free to take one, or if you want to pass another one along to someone, take a couple. The CFF word of the day is shepherd, for Good Shepherd Sunday. I think that's it. Again, thank you to our third graders for their beautiful maybe one day they'll be preaching, huh? Brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.